Very good, my friends. In today's video, we are going to review this trail camera. It's the Blaze Video A280W. It's a Wi-Fi trail camera, Wi-Fi using the standard Wi-Fi that you have in the mobile phone, and it's going to have a maximum range of about 50 meters depending on the obstacles in the middle, and it's going to allow us to see real-time video or download the pictures that you have done with the camera. This could be useful if you put the camera in the height and you have very difficult to access to the camera, or if you are doing video surveillance in your home, will be useful to check the live video. Here is the camera. It came with the antenna that helps to improve the signal of the Wi-Fi connection. In the interior, we find the LCD screen and the buttons. Here there is a socket that allows us to connect external battery or an AC-DC transformer that works at 12 volts. It has as well a USB socket that will allow us to download the pictures or video directly to the PC. Here is where the SD card is connected. It accepts SD card up to 512 GB. It has a LCD color screen of 2.4 inches. It works with 8 AA batteries. All the other cameras I had were capable to work only with 4 batteries, but in this case this camera works as 12 volts and it's mandatory to put 8 batteries. I use nickel thin rechargeable batteries that works at 1.6 volts. This way I don't have to spend a lot of money in batteries.
It came with 3 motion detector sensors, one in the front and 2 in the sides.
It has 32 high efficiency infrared LEDs that will allow us to record at night. Infrared light is not visible, so people will not be able to find the camera. Here is the microphone to record the sound as well, and there is an adapter for a tripod. In the box came the camera, the antenna, the belt to attach it to a tree. The belt is 1.5 meters long. Inside the box we find the instructions that came in several languages, including English, Spanish, French, Italian. And finally the USB cable that will allow us to connect the camera to the PC.
During these days I have a problem with a fox that has entered where the hens are, and it has killed 2 of the hens. So I'm going to use the camera to see if I can capture this fox while it's trying to access the sun with the hens. Now I have 4 hands, but I think I found where he was entering. We will see some of the pictures and evidence I have.
The fox entered from the neighbor's house walking along the ledge of the wall. How I know it? Well, the fox left footprints on the wall.
I think now the fox cannot enter here because this is protected. I'm going to place the camera here.
Let's see if the fox tries to access tonight. And yes, there is the fox. He is trying to find a way to access and eat the hens. He already killed 8 hens from a near neighbor.
Okay, let's go to the forest and place the camera and see what we can get from there. Okay, I'm going to place the camera somewhere over this forest. I hopefully will get out footage of the fox that eat my hens and other animals. Okay, I'm going to place the camera here. It's very easy to install one of these cameras. You just need to find a good tree in a good position and just use the belt that came with the camera. Okay. There looks good. Now I'm going to connect to the application and we are going to see what it's going to record the camera. To be able to connect to the camera, I need first to turn it on.
I'm using an application called Trailcam Mobile.
Okay, let's turn on the camera, close it again. Cool. So, connect. It will take a few seconds to connect to the camera. Okay, turning on the Wi-Fi, scanning for the Wi-Fi. La la la. Connect. Okay, start. So now we are connected to the Wi-Fi. I'm going to click on camera. And I can adjust the footage in front of the camera. Okay. Maybe we need to place it a little lower. We can adjust. The video goes very fast, so the reaction is... quite fast. Okay, there is only 1 or 2 seconds of delay, which is fine. I'm going to get it really low, like this, and pointed to that side. Cool. Little bit stronger. And this branch here, we don't want it in the middle, not this one. Pretty good. I'm going to take a video, so you will be able to test the quality of the camera during the day. Hello, testing the audio and quality of the camera. I'm 3 meters from the camera, 2.5 meters from the camera, and this is how it looks like. Cool. I'm going to stop the recording of the video. Let's check. We have battery. Excellent. Settings. Good. Battery, temperature, camera time, synchronize. Look, the time of the camera is wrong. It's 4th of September. I just need to click on camera time and time synchronized. Success. Now is the correct date and time. Okay, we are going to leave the camera here for the night, and tomorrow I will see which pictures and videos I took from the camera. Okay, don't forget to press the start button. Start. And when we click start, okay, start. Okay. Countdown, and in 30 seconds it's going to start to record. Let's leave it here for the night. Focus is fixed, so depending how far or close the subject is, they may be out of focus. So a good enhancement for the camera will be out of focus. Here you can see 2 pictures I took with the camera. In the first one, I'm out of focus because I'm very close. In the second one, I'm in focus. This is taken at maximum quality, 32 megapixels. Okay, let's see, the camera is still there and no one has found it. Okay, I'm going to access the camera and download the last pictures. On the Google Store you find for Trail Cam Mobile. Okay, you have to install this application. I have it already installed. I click open. Allow. The Bluetooth is turned off, so it needs the Bluetooth to first start the Wi-Fi. And when the Wi-Fi is started, then you can connect to the camera. Okay, connect, connect. Okay, battery is 27%. I will need to recharge the batteries. Okay, let's see if we have any new videos. I leave it for all the week, and yes, we have new pictures, new videos.
Let's download three videos and let's see how long it takes. Click here, allow to download. What I like about this camera is that downloading for the Wi-Fi is not super slow like in other cameras I previously had, like the dash camera I have in the car or other trail cameras I tested in the past. This one is quite fine. Downloading three videos of 20 seconds, it just takes like 40 seconds, 1 minute. We will see later. I just will count. Okay, now I have the videos on my mobile phone. Okay, if I go to local and I click on play, we can see one of the videos. This one, there is nothing. Let's see if we got anything here. Yes, there is a whiteboard in this video. And let's see this one. Nothing. The high mode gets triggered by anything. So Medium was working quite fine. So we can click on and see what is currently in the SD card of the camera. In the settings, we can do everything that you can do in the normal settings from the keyboard and the screen on the camera. Here I'm going to change back. I'm going to put back the peer sensitivity to medium because in high it's more comfortable to change from here maybe. Look, it has this synchronized, but probably it's because the batteries are running very low. Okay, let's remove the camera from here and turn it off, and we are ready to go. Okay, let's check quickly how the camera works. Okay, to turn on the camera, we just need to switch this button here. To access the pictures and video we have made, we click on OK, and then we can see the pictures and video we have made. To reproduce a video, we need to click on the right arrow, and then the video will start to play. It doesn't have speakers, you cannot hear the sound. Okay, to exit the menu, we click here and here, then we see live video, what we are recording. To start recording, we click this button here. The camera is going to wait 30 seconds and it's going to start to capture video when it detects motion, or it's going to start the time lapse if it's configured for time lapse. To exit this mode, we click start again, and this will bring us back to the main screen. Then to access the menu, we click here menu. We have several options. We can disable the Wi-Fi. We can select the mode. There are two modes: motion detection, it will work only when there is motion detected, or time lapse. Then we have the possibility to take picture or video, or picture plus video when there is a motion detection. The quality of the pictures can be up to 32 megabytes. You can take one picture or up to 5 pictures every time the camera detects movement. The video quality can be set to these three options. The video length you can select by daytime or night. I have set it to 20 seconds. Then you can select if you want to record the sound or not. You can select the video format, MP4 and MOV. I detected that MP4 is easy for your phone to reproduce. This is the time to wait after detecting motion. If you don't want to be spending a lot of battery, maybe you don't want to take pictures very frequently. Peer section, peer sensitivity. You have three levels. You can decide if you want to use the side detectors or only the front one. Motion test, you can set the camera in motion test to see if the camera detects you in a far position or where the animals will be likely to be. We can test this.
Okay, let's test the motion test.
So can you see how the red LED turn on when it detects movement? So this is going to allow us to see if the camera movement sensor is working properly and how far it can detect the animal. So as you see, if I move the arm, the LED turns red. Okay, let's see how far it can get us. Okay, I'm 4 meters and it's detecting me. It's still detecting me. Impressive. Okay.
You can set up the time lapse interval. You can take one picture every hour or whatever you select. You can select your time zone. This is important for the date to be displayed properly. Date and time, you can put it here or you can synchronize with the mobile phone, which is easier. You can select the date format you want to show. I'm going to select this one because it's the most standardized. You can select the time format, 24 hours or 12 hours. You can set if you want to display the camera name, the info strip. If you want to do loop recording will remove the videos if the SD card gets full. The SD card can be up to 512 gigabytes. You can select the operating hours. I have it enabled, but I'm going to disable. If you enable, you can select when to start record and when to stop recording. You can set a password for the Wi-Fi and to access the menu of the camera and the videos and render recordings. The language, you have the possibility to set up in different languages. And you can format the SD card from here. You can perform as well a factory reset and everything will come back to normal. And here is the camera model and the version of the firmware that is used. This is all. I hope this video has been useful for you. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, like the video. Thank you for watching and see you in next video.